American Top 40.
Together with her husband, Jerry Goffin, this girl forms one of the most successful songwriting teams in America. Up on the Roof, Locomotion, Will You Love Me Tomorrow, that great one by the Shirelles, Take Good Care of Your Baby by, or My Baby by Bobby V, are a sample of the 24 or so smash hits that they've written. But the young lady is also a singer, and she had a big hit, her only one, in 1962. Her song, It Might As Well Rain Until September. Her name, Carole King.
What should I write?
Carole King, It Might As Well Rain Till September, an oldie on American Top 40.
American Top 40.
Now the current hit, a debut tune sung by the most successful female songwriter in the business. The last time she sang her way into the Top 40 was 9 years ago. But as a songwriter collaborating with Jerry Goffin, she practically had a lease on the high end of the record charts. Up on the Roof, Locomotion, Will You Love Me Tomorrow, Take Good Care of My Baby, just a small sample of the 25 hits that she's had her name on writing for other singers. And now, she's writing for herself. From her new album, Tapestry, here's her hit single debuting at number 38. It's called It's Too Late. Here's Carole King.
Stayed in bed all morning, it's too late.
Carole King, It's Too Late. At number 38, a debut song in American Top 40. And the countdown rolls on.
American Top 40.
This is Casey Kasem on American Top 40. And now, the biggest hit of the year so far by a solo act. It's by a female vocalist, and it held the number one spot for 5 consecutive weeks. This artist had her first hit as a singer 9 years ago, and she hasn't had another until this year. But her main bag has been songwriting. At least a couple of dozen of her compositions have been major hits. But this one has been her most major, because she sings it too, like nobody else could have. At number 11 this week, the song that was number 1 for 5 consecutive weeks, longer than any other by a solo artist so far this year, Carole King's It's Too Late. 13 weeks on AT40, and the oldest song in the Top 40. At number 11, Carole King and It's Too Late, and the countdown rolls on. Well, now, let's dig into the AT40 Book of Records and take a look at the most successful female singer-songwriter of the 70s.
Now I'm no longer doubtful of what I'm living for.
I mentioned a few minutes ago that one of the major developments in popular music during this decade has been the emergence of women in rock music. Among the ladies who have written or co-written material they've performed on hit singles and albums are Joni Mitchell, Janis Ian, Roberta Flack, Helen Reddy, Melissa Manchester, Barbara Streisand, Ann and Nancy Wilson of Heart, and Carly Simon. A large and impressive group of talent, but it doesn't include the name of the lady at the top of the list. Although she was immensely successful during the 60s as one half of a writing partnership with her husband, Jerry Goffin, this lady didn't actively begin her career as a vocalist until she launched it with a big bang in the spring of 1971. In June of that year, she hit number 1 on the Billboard pop chart and stayed there for 5 consecutive weeks with a huge double-sided smash, It's Too Late, backed with I Feel the Earth Move. Altogether during this decade, she's put a total of 10 records in the top 40. 3 of them have been double-sided hits, and 4 of them have made it into the top 10. And every one of them was written and sung by Carole King, the most successful female singer-songwriter of the 1970s. And that's another entry in our AT40 Book of Records. Now, on with the countdown.
American Top 40.
Well, now on AT40, we're up to the current hit by the most successful female songwriter of the rock era. Her name? Carole King. She was born Carole Klein in Brooklyn back in 1941. And by age 14, she had formed her own vocal group called The Cosines. By the time this woman was 17, she'd already been signed by famous music publisher Don Kirshner to a contract as a songwriter. A few months later, she married a young record producer and her songwriting collaborator, Jerry Goffin, and her career really got underway. Over the years, the songs she's written or co-written have hit the charts a total of 98 times, and 6 of them went all the way to number 1. There was Bobby V's Take Good Care of My Baby, The Shirelles' Will You Love Me Tomorrow, Little Eva's and Grand Funk's The Locomotion, Steve Lawrence's and Donny Osmond's separate versions of Go Away Little Girl, James Taylor's You've Got a Friend, and her own number one recording, It's Too Late. Writing or co-writing all those songs has made Carole King the most successful female songwriter in the history of the charts. This week, Carole King is in our countdown with a song she wrote nearly 20 years ago. The Chiffons took it to number 5 back in 1963, and this week, Carole King is at number 14 and moving up with her remake of the song, One Fine Day. At number 14 in the countdown this week on American Top 40, Carole King with One Fine Day. 13 big hits to number 1 and counting them down. Well, now, the current hit by the singer and songwriter who helped her babysitter get a number one record before she herself managed to do it. In the early 60s, Carole King and Jerry Goffin, wife and husband at the time, were the hottest songwriting team in the business. Now, their string of hits for various singers included three number ones, Go Away, Little Girl, Will You Love Me Tomorrow, and Take Good Care of My Baby. In 1962, they became aware that their babysitter, Eva Boyd, was just itching to become a pop singer. So, they wrote a song for her, produced a recording session, and arranged to have the single released. It hit number one. A song called The Locomotion, with their singing babysitter billed as Little Eva. Well, Carole wanted to be a singer, too. In fact, she had a top 30 hit about the same time. But it took Carole 9 years to equal her babysitter's feat of hitting number one, which she finally did in 1971 with It's Too Late. Her latest hit is at number 16 this week. Here's Carole King, who treats her babysitters very well, with One Fine Day. Falling from number 12, where it's been for a couple of weeks, down to number 16, Carole King and One Fine Day.
Casey's Coast to Coast.
In the early 70s, songwriters who performed their own songs were a particularly powerful force. Folks like James Taylor, Laura Nero, Jackson Brown, Don McLean, and Joni Mitchell gained huge followings. And leading the pack was a super talented woman from New York City who'd actually gotten her start years earlier writing pop songs with her husband, Jerry Goffin. In 1971, Carole King wrote, sang, and recorded an album called Tapestry that would go on to sell 10 million copies and win 4 Grammys, including Record of the Year for It's Too Late. That song and the album Tapestry went on to become number one simultaneously on June 19th, 1971. That's Carole King with her Grammy-winning smash, It's Too Late. I'm Casey Kasem on our Y2K special, The 40 Days That Changed Music. Yeah.